In this video, we will update the firmware on our Garmin Montana GPS using our smartphone and Garmin Connect, as opposed to using Garmin Express and a USB cable. You can see here we have the Montana 700 turned on and connected to Garmin Connect. We will do a sync, and if there is a firmware available, it will transfer it from our phone to the device itself. Now at this point, let's flip over to the Montana 700 and continue on. So from the main menu for demonstrative purposes, we're gonna go into setup and then about just to show you the latest version of the firmware that's currently installed on the device. You can see here at the very top, it says a 6.3. Now I do know there is a 6.4 available as of October 2020. So we're gonna turn off the device and turn it back on. Now, if we were using Garmin Express, we would get a prompt to disconnect the USB cable and to do the step, but we don't have this step in this process. So now we're gonna watch the startup. You can see down at the bottom, we have all the different modules loading up, but this one here that's not changing, it's called checking for new SW or software. That is your hint that there's some new software available. So after a few seconds, you should see the screen, new software found. Now we can tap no and use our GPS using the old firmware, or we can tap yes. Now, next time you restart your Montana 700, you will get the same screen again. So now it's gonna restart. It's gonna load up the software loader. And now you can see the progress of the firmware being updated. Now for this type of update via Garmin Connect and your smartphone, I don't think this will apply to the TopoActive map updates, where these file sets are 3, 4, 5 gigs in size. I think you might still need to use the Garmin Express and USB cable method, but at least for firmware, you can use the smartphone method. And once it's done applying the firmware, you can see it's gonna restart. You can see where it's checking for new software. It just skipped right through that. And now we're back to our main menu. We're gonna go back to our setup and about to confirm that a new firmware version has been installed. And there it is, 6.4. And there you go.